My name is Angelina, aka Crush Glamour. I'm going to do a makeup tutorial only using this LA Colors in the nude palette. And I'm going to insert a picture showing all the products that I'll be using. Okay, now that we've gotten that out of the way, I'm going to start this tutorial.
Wet your beauty blender until it expands. Wring it out until it's damp. Dip your favorite foundation in it and start blending it into your skin. Make sure you get behind the nose, the eyelids, forehead, everywhere. I applied some face powder onto my brush and in small circular motions, I'm blending it into the entirety of my face. Dip a flat brush into the black pigment from the palette and for natural eyebrows, fill in the gaps. Shimmer lip gloss with a subtle undertone of silver in it. Lip gloss can easily be the most overpowering thing you can put on your face. I like to put it on beforehand so I can tailor my eyes to the intensity of the color on my mouth. Now I'm going to use this purpley gray metallic eyeshadow from the palette. I really love how shimmery and beautiful this color is, so I'm going to apply it onto my lids using a sponge tip brush. I don't want the glitter to go where it's not supposed to go, so I'm cleaning it up with a Q-tip. Start building value and layers of your eyeshadow by dragging this purple-gray eyeshadow into a line from the corner of your eyes with your sponge tip brush. Make sure everything is even and flows into the tip. Dip your flat brush into the black pigment. Blend it on the boundary dividing the tip of your eyelid and the bottom of your brow bone. Make sure you distribute the black pigment evenly through long and slow strokes, making sure you drag the pigment towards your inner tear ducts, not completely going there because you want your eyes to be open to look more awake. Use the same color layering technique, making a wing with your flat brush, allowing the purple wing to peep underneath. Make sure all the black lines are aligned with one another. In quick upward strokes, straighten your eyeshadow wings with your artisan brush after dipping it into your face powder. Using your fluffy brush, make sure that you blend the black eyeshadow into your crease, making sure that there are no harsh lines. As you can see, I'm rebuilding value by going back into the black eyeshadow. Putting on makeup is the same concept of drawing. It requires a lot of back and forth between shading and blending. Now that's my favorite part, the eyeliner. As you can see, I don't start directly into the inner tear ducts. First, start with shorter strokes and gradually build it into longer ones. Make sure that the lines meet up at the same point. Ultimately creating a long, smooth line that's even in thickness. Are you ready for the wing now? Let's do it. Extending from the outer corner of your eye. Make sure that it points in the direction of the tip of your eyebrow. Connect this line to the main part of your eyeliner, making a hypotenuse, and fill it in. To ensure a razor-sharp wing, do that part last. Liquid eyeliner on my waterline irritates my eyes, so I like to use cream. Connect it to your wing, ensuring your line is even in thickness. Because my eyeliner on my waterline is so thick, I'm lining it with a liquid eyeliner, so it's not going in direct contact with my waterline, but it is being used as a barrier. I'm taking that black pigment, rebuilding some of that value again. Make sure the tip of your eyeliner wing and black eyeshadow wing are aligned. Now I'm putting on a little mascara. I like how this applicator is slightly bent, so it's easy for me to put on mascara on my lower lashes. After I put on my makeup, I decided it was subtle enough for me to put on a deeper color on my lips. So I put this lip stain that is initially sparkly white, then it slowly changes color according to your body temperature, darkening to a deep pink. Put powder around your mouth so your gloss wouldn't bleed. This makeup look is also subtle enough to be intensified with red lipstick as well.
And here is the final look. A subtle smoky eye. And you're not really able to see the purple shimmer that I used, but it is very purpley and subdued and shimmery, and it looks very sophisticated. I use products that are very inexpensive, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and it kind of enlightened you and it was very informative, and bye.